It is a perfect spring night in Central Illinois as Fox Sportsnet brings you the Illinois High School Association Boys Class A Baseball Championship, featuring the Cardinals of Pleasant Plains against the Highlanders of Driscoll High School in Addison. And welcome to Lanphier Park, Robin Roberts Stadium, any way you call it. It is a beautiful, beautiful night. Along with David Kaplan, I'm Mike Lederman. The Class A Baseball Championship about to take place here in Central Illinois. It's quite a contrast of styles between Pleasant Plains and Driscoll. The Driscoll guys, they love to swat the ball all over the yard, David. Pleasant Plains, they like that Whitey Herzog small ball, as their coach likes to call it.
Right, both coaches, Mike, like to use former Major League managers to emulate and to play their type of styles. I talked with Jeff Sefcik over at Driscoll. He says, I'm Sparky Anderson with my pitching staff, quick hook, and I'm Earl Weaver, always playing for the big inning. Conversely, over at Pleasant Plains, they have bunted successfully on the suicide squeeze 49 of 53 times this year. One game a few years ago, this coach decided he'd have 42 consecutive hitters bunt. They will play for the single run.
Oh, the parents were thrilled about that, but the coach did live to coach another game, and he's done quite a job. At Pleasant Plains, this school has already won the State A basketball title. No school has ever won both baseball and basketball in the same year, and most of the basketball team is on the baseball team as well, and the leader of both squads. Dusty Bensko, what an outstanding athlete.
Well, he pitched earlier today to pitch them into this championship game. He'll now be at shortstop, an outstanding hitter, hitting 660 this year. That's right, you heard me correct, 660. He's an outstanding athlete. He can run, throw, defend. He does it all.
We must tell you, truth in advertising. His mom keeps the stats. Addison Driscoll, they're starting this century as they finish the last. Right on top. They had three state championships in the 90s. They're going for a fourth today under Jeff Sefcik. Actually, his third, the school's fourth. And boy, they are led by a host of players. Nobody really outstanding, but someone terrific by the name of Kuhns, and he's really been hitting the ball all over the place.
Right, Chris Kuhns is a young man who has broken Jeff Sefcik's school record for home runs, driven in over 50 this season. Also a very good defender with a very strong arm. This is a team that can play long ball at any time.
Well, let's take a look at the pitching matchup. As you know, this tournament packs three games into 2 days, so that can really stretch a pitching staff. Got a couple of right-handers going tonight.
That's right. Jordan Roth, a sophomore, 6'5", is going to pitch for Pleasant Plains. He's more of a junk baller, 82 to 84 on the fastball. Really good, though, with movement in terms of his breaking ball and his slider. Eddie Spichalski, another sophomore, two sophomores in the state championship on the mound tonight. Spichalski can hit 92 on the gun, consistently 86 to 88. Outstanding movement. He is a warrior, according to his head coach.
Both these teams have won over 30 games this season. Here's the big one. We'll be back to bring it to you right after this. Due to time constraints, we move to further action later in the game. Moving to the top of the second, as you see the sun coming over the deck of the stadium here at Lanphier Park. No score, Pleasant Plains and Addison Driscoll. Take a look at some of the keys to this one. One of them is to keep the sun out of your eyes. Brought to you by Hyundai. And for Pleasant Plains, as you said earlier, David, it's run, run, run.
Right. This is a team that looks to steal at every opportunity. They will also bunt, bunt, bunt. As we told you, Coach Greer had one team bunt 42 consecutive times. And with Driscoll, it's go with the pitch. Don't try and pull everything. Put the ball in play. For both teams, play the perfect seven. You don't want to make errors. Errors are really a killer, especially when you're playing in such a pressure-packed environment like tonight.
Joe Alsmeyer hits one off the pitcher's gloves. Plenty of time. Of course, Spychowski. One pitch, one away.
He's very quick off the mound. Very good athlete. Got the glove up quickly. It's amazing you see some pitchers. They really don't feel their position. They don't come off the mound ready to feel their position. And then you see a guy like a Greg Maddux who goes down not only maybe as the best pitcher in the last 20 years, but also the best fielding pitcher perhaps of all time.
Here is Ryan Nelson. Nelson, the senior right fielder. 6'3", 215, gets a hold of this one. Base hit number two for Pleasant Plains.
Nice piece of hitting, got a pitch in the zone, turned on it quickly and drove it into left field. Fastball right down the middle of the plate. And that's what you dream for. Get that fastball, come right there, right on the hands, and get an opportunity to really turn on it.
Curveball to Jesteraco, the third baseman, in for a strike. One out, runner on first, Nelson. not a big threat to steal, but again, Dave Greer, coach of Pleasant Plains, will send just about everybody, including his assistant coaches.
We told you in the open, Dave Greer has suicide squeezed this year with his club. 53 times, 49 of them have worked, and in 95, a team he took to the state tournament, five consecutive hitters suicide squeezed and every one worked.
And he said, can you imagine what the parents were saying about me?
Yeah.
But it's worked. He has built this program. They didn't even have decent uniforms before he took over. He was telling us that they were blue and red, and he called them clown suits. 0-2 now to DiRocco. Spychalski. Plenty of time for Albsmeyer to get, for Ryan Nelson to get back. On deck, the second baseman, Aaron Zirko. Could be 2-1. Hernandez, 6-3 DP.
Taylor made. You see that one on the Sunday hop, you take it yourself, gun it to first, easy double play.
Things are moving along. Pleasant Plains gets another hit. Double play, no errors, nobody left. Through 1.5, still no score. Bottom half of the second inning, the Class A Illinois High School Association Baseball Championship. No score, Pleasant Plains and Driscoll High. The broadcast rights for this Illinois High School Association Class A baseball event have been granted to Fox Sports Net and Intersport Television by the IHSA. Any unauthorized reproduction or rebroadcast of this event is prohibited. Along with David Kaplan, I'm Mike Lederman, Jim Corno Jr. manning the Fox Sports Net truck with our very happy to be out here crew. And here's one right on the helmet as Jordan Roth says hello to his opposing pitcher. It was an off-speed pitch by Chowski. Roth says something to him like he really didn't mean it, but watch it here, right on the coconut. Ooh.
That one stuns you more than it hurts. Thank goodness for the helmet.
So Spychalski is on, but they're going to send in a pinch runner, which may or may not have anything to do with him getting dinged up a little bit.
Now, the way the IHSA rule reads is you may have a courtesy runner for your catcher or pitcher at any time. You may run for any other player one time, and they can re-enter, and that pinch runner then would be done for the game. You cannot re-enter a second time if you have a pinch runner.
Steve McHouston, the pinch runner, a sophomore. And the batter is Jeremy Fisher, the catcher, who had himself a big afternoon in the semifinal with a couple of doubles and a run batted in. You hear the train in the background, another part of the color here in Springfield. The train goes right by right field, and that pickoff play almost got McHouston. Down the left field line and out of play.
Hit and run play on there by Jeff Sefcik trying to get something going. As you look at this Pleasant Plains team, Needham, the catcher, does not have the best arm. He's outstanding at blocking pitches, very much in control behind the plate, but does not have a shotgun to throw runners out.
Again, the throw to first. 1-1 count on Jeremy Fisher, 5'10", 185-pound catcher. Left-handed batter. Runner does not go this time. Pitch in the dirt. Blocked nicely there by Needham. And counts 2-1. The lights are on here. Again, the pickoff. And again, the runner back. We are in twilight. Well, still a lot of sun out, and again they go.
Very concerned on this pitch on a 2-1. Certainly could be looking at a hit and run opportunity here.
There goes the runner. Pitch outside. They got a shot at him, but throw in the dirt, and McHouston seals second base. That almost looked like a pitch out, David. It was so far outside.
Yeah, slow breaking ball, which immediately gives the base runner an advantage. He got a very good jump, advantage number two. Plus, you have a catcher that doesn't have the strongest arm. Now, if you watch the play, the throw comes down. Not a bad throw. Just short hops the bag, though.
And a 3-1 count. Nobody out. Runner on second base. First mini threat of the game. And a good cut and a good pitch, so it's count full of 3-2. Jeremy Fisher, the catcher. Good study of Roth. And timeout called. Fisher batting .387, 15 doubles, 3 triples, a couple of homers, 34 runs batted in. Jeff Sefcik likes him to go with the pitch instead of trying to pull just about everything. And that one right off the foot.
That stings.
You know what happens in the majors when that happens, right? Everybody starts yapping because it goes right off the doggies.
Absolutely.
Okay.
You got it.
There'll be no shortage of cliches tonight, David, but we won't play them one at a time.
We'll save them up.
Okay. To left field. Playing deep, but now with room. Kastner makes the catch. One away, runner does not advance. And that will bring up the designated hitter, Brett Lettenberger. Lettenberger, a sophomore, only 5'8". A couple of doubles on the season. Came up from the sophomore team. Played some second base, now he's DHing. On the outside corner, strike one.
Good looking breaking ball. Doesn't throw a crisp breaking ball with great velocity that could resemble a slider. It's a slow, tantalizing pitch, but you got to really hang in there. If you pull out, it's really going to get you.
And that caught the outside corner, 0-2.
Boy, that breaking ball is filthy. I mean, it is tough to hit.
That started across the center of the plate and broke about 8 inches outside. The 0-2 pitch. Right side. Zirko over to the first baseman Pinkerton. Two out, runner moves to third.
You know the old baseball axiom, good pitching always stops good hitting.
There we go.
You've got to always have a deep pitching staff if you want to get this far. Jeff Sefcik was telling me there was a team a couple of years ago that they battled through the same pitcher in 4 different state tournament games.
Here's Tim Sirik, one of the Twins. Sirik, the left fielder. Another off-speed pitch, beautifully dropped in there. Sophomore, 3 hits in the semifinal, including a couple of doubles. Sirik at .340 with a homer and 23 ribbies. 0-1. Inside, 1-1. Jordan Roth working quickly. 1-1 pitch. And again, he's got Sirik chasing.
Done a very nice job so far here early in the ball game, being around the plate, really not pitching out of much trouble.
1 ball, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Run around third is McHouston. In the dirt again. Needham.
Great block.
Doing the job blocking.
Great block. That is as valuable as a base hit to drive in a run. He just saved a run with an outstanding defensive play.
Count even at 2. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Runner leads off third. Popped up. Foul territory. Giving chase the pitcher, Roth. Well, Jordan Roth had more room than he thought. Probably looked away at the last second with the stands coming up on him. No doubt should have made the play.
All right, now watch. He comes racing over. Probably, you're right, saw the stands in front of him, took his eye off it, and played the ball off the heel of the glove.
And not to belabor the point, but that is exactly where the sun is harshest, right there above the third base roof. So another life for Driscoll, another life for Tim Sirik. 2-2 again.
Nice job by Needham to try and frame that pitch. pulled that thing way down. It said, sure, Mr. Umpire, it was in there.
Roth is really crafting this game. Certainly not throwing it, he's pitching it. Third base. Trying to hustle Bensko. Bensko thought he got him. Great play, but it'll go as a base hit, and the run scores. And Driscoll leads it 1-0.
Well, we talked about the catcher making a heck of a stop to save a run, but then the pitcher drops a sure out to end the inning, and it costs you a run. Nice piece of hitting, go the other way with it. It's a rocket to third. Bensko right there for the carom. Good strong arm, just a hair late.
So the first run of the ball game. And now they're gonna check Jess DiRocco. DiRocco took a hard shot in the semifinal, went right off his head. And he was woozy for a couple of minutes, stayed in the game. This one looked like it went off his left arm.
Yeah, he took a throw coming into third, bounced up on a funny angle and caught him right in the face.
That was really a shot, yeah. Ooh. As the runner came around third, just went down, then the runner started to go home. And quickly retreated, so he's okay. First run of the ball game for Driscoll. They lead it 1-0, and here is Chris Sirak. Runner goes, and he's gonna go without a throw as Needham drops the ball. Tim Sirak steals second base. Chris now up there. Chris at 6'1", 206, batting 286 with a homer and 26 ribbies. Needham didn't have a chance on this.
No chance.
Back to live action, pitches low ball two. Here's the 2-0. Right down the middle, 2-1. Jeff Sefcik loves this kid at third base. He made a play in the semifinal that could well have saved the ball game against Tutopoulos. Two outs and two runners on down the line going to his right, taking a double away from the batter.
Good looking pitch on the corner, painted the black. Very tough pitch to hit.
Counts even, 2-2, runner on second base. Tim Sirak, Chris Sirak from Jordan Roth. First Coach, step off the rubber.
Coach Sefcik was saying, we were talking before the ball game, so many hitters pull off the baseball, and that if you were willing to pitch the corners, you can be very successful with less than stellar stuff.
2-2, foul it.
Then you have a guy like Jordan Roth who has very good stuff, makes him even tougher to hit because he's really good at moving the ball in and out.
That foul ball almost took the head off the first base coach, Steve DeTomo. Steve, his reflexes are still there. Nice to see, there he is. Good friend of Jeff's from grade school days. Still two balls, two strikes, two outs. Driscoll with a run in, runner on second base. Second base to his left, base hit. Coming at the score is Tim Sirak. Chris on first with his base hit, and it's 2-0.
But again, you talk about the little things in the ballgame as Coach Greer comes out to settle his guys down. A drop pop up in foul territory would have ended the inning with nothing scoring. Instead, two runs for Driscoll. They capitalize on little mistakes.
There's the conference at the mound as you see the play. Clean base hit through the right side. And Tim Sirak scores, so it's 2-0 Driscoll and the conference on the mound. Jordan Roth has had plenty of rest. He last pitched in the sectional, winning. And he is
pitched on Monday.
Yeah, getting nicked up today. It's been called the Nightline of Sports Television. Jim Rome interviews the biggest names and tackles the hottest topics in sports on The Last Word. Don't miss The Last Word with Jim Rome tonight after Sports Geniuses on Fox Sports Net. Well, the conference breaks up. Raw Roth has given up a couple of hits this inning. Of course, the drop foul pop.
Just was talking with the official scorer, and he said he is not scoring the drop pop an error. It was a long run plus the sun. I made it a very tough play. He's right.
Okay. There is Seppi Hernandez, the senior shortstop. Seppi's had a home run in the tournament. Inside. Two balls, no strikes, the count on Hernandez. Seppi, a senior at 5'10", 167, has come alive with the bat in the tournament. Could be trouble. Charging at third, nice play, DiRocco. And Driscoll is retired, but they get a couple of runs, a couple of hits, no errors. One man left. We're through two innings now. And Driscoll High leads the Class A championship 2-0. Driscoll High breaking through with a couple of runs in the bottom of the second. We move to the third. They lead it over Pleasant Plains 2-0. The Windy City Showdown returns. Chicago bragging rights are on the line when Sammy Sosa brings the Cubs to the south side to battle Frank of the White Sox. Coverage starts in a special one-hour game room. Cubs and Sox Sunday at noon on Fox Sportsnet. All right, top of the third inning. This is Aaron Zirko fouling off the pitch from Ed Spychowski.
Tell you what, basketball, football, track, tennis, they're all great sports. I can't imagine anything better than being out in the green grass in 78-degree weather. It's gorgeous conditions. This is just flat out awesome.
And you're getting paid, David. This one to the right side and through.
Getting paid to watch baseball is like winning the lottery. This is not working.
Second, third hit for Pleasant Plains. And the leadoff man is on, and Zirko. And that'll bring up Jeremy Pinkerton.
Nice piece of hitting here. Pitch is down. He goes and gets it. Flares it into right field. Really nice job.
Chris Sirek shortens up at third, and Jeremy Pinkerton, the first baseman, the batter. Pinkerton has not hit much this season, only 14 at-bats with three hits. Good defensively. He's getting a start here as a senior in the state championship game. Shows the bunt, and the pitch is a strike.
No, calling him hit. Hit by pitch.
Ah, the right hand went up, and the ruling was hit batter. Okay. So a threat now for Pleasant Plains. First and second, nobody out. Let's see if we can tell here. There's the square around. Guess it got him on the right, maybe inside the right leg. So, runners on first and second. Circle moving to second base. Pinkerton over on first. And the second trip through the lineup now for Pleasant Plains. Here's Bo Gum. Got an infield single to start the game. Ball one.
That was tough to tell. It must have caught a little piece of the uniform. I guess you want that baggy uniform.
Brad Stearns was emphatic on the call. Again fakes the bunt, and they throw to second base. Well, Fisher on cork one trying to pick Zirko off of second base.
Jeremy Fisher has a cannon. I mean, he really didn't get set to throw that. Just looked down and boom, it was gone.
One count. Inside ball two. We've seen a lot of throw throughs and pickoffs to second attempted. In general, in high school baseball, it's a low percentage play. There's so many times when you see that ball just short hopping and rolling into the outfield and causing much more grief than the coaches care to admit. 2-1 pitch to the right side. Nice play by the second baseman. Then he kicks it. Still with time to go to first. No. Gasparri maybe took his eye off the ball. And the bases are loaded.
There's a pitch. It's a fastball away. Tries to take it to right field.
Gasperi just doesn't come up with it, can't find the handle. By the time he does, good base running, beats the throw to first.
And the error goes to Rich Gasperi, the second baseman. And Pleasant Plains has got something going. Bases loaded, nobody out. Tyler Kastner, who sacrificed his first trip. Now, a great shot on improving his season output of 19 runs batted in. Kastner, a junior, 180-pounder. There are his numbers. Excellent bunter. They might squeeze it here.
I think you've got to play, Mike, when you get a chance against a quality arm and a great team. You've got to play for the big inning here.
Not showing bunt at all. This one will bring a run in. Nice play by the first baseman. Nobody's covering. Kuhns made the stop. He wasn't going to get the man at home, but Spychowski didn't cover, and it was far too late for Gasperi to come over. And it's a 2-1 ball game, as all he could do is put the ball in his pocket.
Well, Spychowski has to get over to first. That ball's hit, boom. You have got to break, and then you turn and run up the baseline. He looks, there's nobody there by this point. The second baseman comes racing over and says, I'm here to try and help, but it's too late.
Official score, I guess, gives him the single. Zirko comes in. Base is still loaded. It's a 2-1 ball game. And here is Dusty Bensko. Oh. Just the person Pleasant Plains wants up in this situation. Base is loaded. Nobody out.
And a 660 hitter stepping into the box. Yeah.
15 home runs. Wind is blowing out to left. Good fastball inside corner. There's a good look at Lamphere Park. 320 down the lines, 375 in the alleys. The 1-1, oh, there it goes. Deep left field, way back. Look at it.
That ball is jacked. Dusty Bensko just turned on that pitch and got it all. Get out the rye bread and the mustard.
Oh.
Grand salami time.
Howard over the left center field alley, close to 400 feet to the left of the 350 sign. And Dusty Bensko, home run number 16 at Ribby, 61, 2, 3, and 4.
What a beautiful swing. Watch how his body doesn't really have much movement. The hands come through the zone so beautifully. Watch this. You don't see the body all over the place, the arms flailing, the bat waving. Boom, just a picture of concentration. That pitch is in his wheelhouse. Now watch this, here it comes, and he catches all of it.
Here's Jordan Roth as he comes back to live action. This one popped up to right. Kenders is there, and there's one away. First five batters reached. And they all scored for Pleasant Plains.
Now you've got a sophomore on the hill in both cases for both clubs, but here with Spychowski, you've got to really look at him and hope that he doesn't get rattled. He's not a veteran in terms of being a senior that's been through tough innings before. You really have to settle him down when you get him to the dugout.
Albsmeyer. Bounce back to the box, his first trip. Takes that one outside, counts 1-1. Outside corner, 1-2.
Boy, Spychowski's a quick worker.
Way outside, 2-2.
We all remember Steve Traxel.
Please.
Days as a Cub. But watch how quick Spychowski's already set. He's ready to go, waiting on the hitter.
Time called. Alsmaier back in the box. I love the high school rule where you have to keep 1 foot in the batter's box. None of that delay stuff. Up high, they appeal to the first base umpire. And Mikaski says, uh-uh. Here's Mike. From Lincoln, Illinois.
Full count. Fouled it back here.
That was headed right for my Jeep.
We've set up a protective screen, by the way, around your Jeep.
Thank you very much.
With my car. One out. Again, the 3-2. Right in there, strike three, and Elbsmeyer knew it.
That's a heck of a breaking ball. That's a knee buckler. Nasty curve. Catches the inside corner, and he absolutely knew it.
First strikeout for Ed Spychalski.
Watch this pitch catch the corner. Really good. Look at that.
No.
Bye-bye.
And here's Ryan Nelson. Nelson, single to left his first time up. Five runs in this inning for Pleasant Plains. They lead it 5-2. Two outs, nobody on. Straight ahead, center field, Matt Butler. And Spychalski gets the last three batters, but the first five did lots of damage. Four runs, three hits, there was an error, nobody left. 5-2, Pleasant Plains ahead. Once more, due to time constraints, we pick up action later in the game. To the bottom of the fourth inning we go, Driscoll. Trying to get something going here. Lettenberger, the designated hitter, leading it off against Jordan Roth. Brett 0-for-1. Grounded out to the second baseman, his first at bat. Roth has pitched well. Gave up those two runs in the second inning that were really prompted when he couldn't come up with the tough foul pop-up over by third base. That one's up high, 2-0. That cost him a couple of runs, but other than that, he's been in control, got out of a two-out scrape last inning.
I would bet that Jeff Sefcik wants his guys taking until they get a strike on him. It's 3-0 now. Obviously, this is going to be a take situation because you want to start to manufacture a big inning, and you got to get base runners, obviously.
Roth working quickly, 3-0. And that one's right down the middle. The Sirik twins to follow, Tim, then Chris. For Driscoll, here's a 3-1 pitch. Full count.
Good looking pitch on the corner. There you see Jeff Sefcik, one of the top high school coaches, not just in Illinois, but in this country. He's won, I believe they've won, this will be their fourth state title if they can win tonight. He's won a couple already. Yeah. This would be his third.
His third. Went to school at Driscoll and played ball. Learned under the former coach, Rod Molek, a fine, fine coach and a great guy.
And actually, Chris Coons broke Jeff Sefcik's home run record.
Yeah. Now he says, I want a record for myself. So he wants to be the first coach to win three state titles in baseball. So the base on balls with Lettenberger on first. Now here's Tim Sirak, who singled, an infield single, came around to score. Back in that second inning. For Driscoll, and we're going to get a conference on the mound here as Dave Greer is going to come out and talk to his pitcher.
Dave Greer is very much, as you can tell, he's already had a couple trips to the mound, hands-on manager, coach.
They're so similar, these guys, in personality, Jeff and Dave. You know.
Well, they were funny. I was standing down on the field, I don't know, an hour before the game, and Dave and Jeff shook hands, wished each other luck, and Dave says to Jeff, hey, do me a favor, just take it easy on us tonight. Keep it close. And Jeff said, yeah, okay. Yeah, you're playing for the state championship, and you don't have a very good team, I'm sure. You want me to take it easy.
Nothing like a little rib. Tomorrow we'll have the Astros against the Dodgers. Baseball Thursday on Fox Sports Net. Jeff Bagwell and the Astros take their show to L.A. to battle Sean Green and the Dodgers. Baseball Thursday tomorrow at 8. On Fox Sportsnet. All right. Tim Sirak with a runner on first. Nobody out. His team trailing by three runs. Fouls this one down the left field line into the Driscoll bullpen. I'm Mike Lederman along with David Kaplan. Hope you're enjoying this. A beautiful night for baseball. No fooling. Tim Sirak, those are his numbers. One homer, 23 RBIs. His twin brother Chris on deck.
Doesn't he look like Matt Damon?
I'll have to check.
the ground pass, first base, fair ball.
This will score one.
Runner around third, he's coming home, no question, Lettenberger. And heading for third is Tim Cyrak. He'll go in standing with the triple.
That is a beautiful piece of hitting. And
right inside the bag.
Goodwill hitting. Goodwill hitting for you.
Down the right field line. Watch it here. He just turns on this pitch. Had to go down on his knees for it.
Went down and got it. And just inside the first base bag. Beautiful piece of hitting.
Two of the three runs batted in by Tim Cyrak tonight. Here's brother Chris, who can knock in his brother. Nobody out. 5-3 ball game. Good pitch outside corner, strike one. Pleasant Plains 5, Driscoll High 3. Winner gets the championship. Nobody out. Bottom of the fourth inning. Ball speed pitch, got the inside corner.
Wow. Cyrak turned as if to say, all right, it's going to hit me in the back. The ball broke in and must have just caught a piece of the corner. Watch him turn. There's the high breaking ball. Turns.
Whoa.
And that ball looks to be a bit inside.
1-2-3 without taking the bat off his shoulder. So Chris Cyrak goes down looking. Second strikeout for Jordan Roth. Now one man out, and this is Hernandez, number nine hitter, but not a number nine out. He has been hitting the ball very well in this playoff, including a home run.
Now I would bet that you'll have a contact play on here by Driscoll. If a ball is hit to either short or second, the runner is gone automatically on contact.
Seppi has been quite a story. Did not start the season well, was benched for several games, then I guess got the message and came back strong.
Ball hit to third, it's going to be close. If the contact plays on, you may have a play at the plate. That hit him.
Hernandez becomes the second hit batsman. He'll go down to first.
Now that's what happens when you throw that really flat, slow breaking ball and you're looking for that sweeping curve. Sometimes if it doesn't really come out of your hand right, it's going to hit the batter.
Yeah, you wonder. He doesn't really make much of an effort to get out of the way, certainly. Just stood there.
No, but that pitch was way inside.
Yeah. He had about 2.5 minutes to get out of the way of that. Here's Matt Butler. Runners on first and third. Tying runs on. Bottom of the fourth inning. Driscoll with a run home. Now down by two. Jordan Roth trying to pitch out of the jam for Pleasant Plains. Here's Butler taking inside. Need him again with a block. It's really something to hear Dave Greer talk about Needham, the catcher. He says, can't throw real well, doesn't hit real well, but boy, is he valuable to us just by keeping the ball in front of him. And we've seen that tonight. That one's up high. 2-0.
You know, a guy can drive in four runs in a game, Mike, but if he misses the cutoff man twice and costs you a couple of runs and makes an error and costs you a run, he really's only produced one run for you. If you look at Needham, he's a guy that keeps you in the ballgame and makes the smart play.
Swing and a miss, 2-1. Gasparri, the second baseman on deck, and there is Ryan Needham. And Needham caught a little last year. And a lot of the pitchers were hesitant. There goes the runner. That was last year. That was this year. Needham throws down to third. Ball gets away, but not far enough away. Needham looked to second, figuring as soon as he threw to second, the runner would try to come in from third. So it's a stolen base, but it could have been a lot worse for Pleasant Plains.
Well, unnecessary throw. Again, you have to think what you're going to do with the baseball. Even a great throw doesn't get it. Comes up firing. Runner's not that far. Even if the throw is caught, you're not going to get the man, so why risk it?
Back to live action. We're 3-2. One out. Tying runs in scoring position. And the pitch to Butler. Foul it back.
may be headed for your Mercedes.
Oh, yeah. Have you seen it?
Nice. Good-looking ride.
Oh. Yes, sirree. Boy, I painted it myself. My Mercedes. From your mouth. All right. And again, time called. Matt Butler, excellent leadoff hitter for Jeff Sefcik. Oh, strike three. And Butler, with a show of emotion there, realized very quickly he better button it up. Another strikeout looking.
That's a big out to get. Huge out. And let's see where this one is. You got to swing at that. That pitch right across the tops of the knees. You've got to swing at it. It's close enough that you can't take it.
I talk about Brad Stern's big strike zone, and he wants you to swing, and justifiably so. Here is Gasparri now with two out. Rich, the second baseman, infield single, and two trips.
Hey, what you get out of this inning here, it's a huge momentum swing for Pleasant Plains, because a triple with a man on, you score a run, you got a man at third and nobody out, and you don't play to anybody else. That's certainly demoralizing to Driscoll Catholic.
Needham again with the block. At third base, Tim Sirek, he's been there for a while. Two strikeouts this inning for Jordan Roth. Not that time. 2-1.
Both bullpens are quiet right now.
Well, Spychowski, I think, could only go one more inning according to the IHSA rules. You can only pitch nine in the tournament. Into the hole and through. This is going to tie the ball game. One run is in. Coming around third to score is Hernandez, and we are tied at five.
Great piece of hitting. Again, with two outs, you just want to get the bat on the ball, put it in play, and see if something can happen. And this one has eyes. Got the head of the bat out on it. Nice looking swing. That's one thing when you watch the Driscoll hitters, they all look alike at the plate because they're so well coached in the fundamentals of hitting. None of the other garbage moving, you're flapping your arm or waving your bat. And here comes two runs home. Ball game tied.
And Chris Kuhns is the batter. Kuhns has been quiet through the semifinal and final so far. The big stick, the home run leader on this team. Two out, runner on first, ball one. Kuhns average, you see, down to 422. 1-0. Okay, just checking the statistics. Spychowski can go more.
Right, the rule is you can go nine per day in the tournament. During the season, there is no pitch rule, no inning rule. You could, theoretically, it never happens, obviously, pitch the same guy every inning of every game until you got to tournament play.
Outside 3-0. The only exception to the rule is if the game goes into extra innings and you're pitching, you can keep that pitcher in there. Falling behind here, 3-0 on Chris Kuhns. Think he'll green light him? Nope.
Taking all the way.
Spychowski is on deck.
Only hitter in this game that would get the green light on 3-0 would be Dusty Bensko.
All tied at five, three runs here.
Has the opportunity and the ability on a pitch like this to take it out of the yard.
No play at first.
Wind not a factor. American flag in dead center field, 415 feet away. Really not moving much.
Here's the 3-1. There goes the runner. Fouled off right side.
There's the flag, very little breeze.
Game time temperature 78 degrees. It has cooled some now with the sun dropping down, the lights you see.
What a great shot towards center field. 4-15 to the bushes.
This is America, folks. I love this. Just the best. Here's a 3-2 as the runner goes. Again through the hole. Third base. And first and third, two out.
Well, nobody over to cover third.
On a single to left field by Chris Kuhns. Gasparri to third. Here's Spychalski.
DiRocco did not get to his position.
Well, they weren't going to get him anyway.
Would have been closer, I think, than...
Took that curveball right where it went.
And he hits second, says, I'm going. Comes churning for third, and there's nobody home.
Dave Greer out to the mound, big conference. So far, Jordan Roth has given up 6 hits. And looks like he's going to stay in the ballgame. Meanwhile, for all the information on the web of the IHSA, any up-to-date stuff on anything, your favorite Illinois high school team or athlete, log on. IHSA, www.ihsa.org, O-R-G. The best their website, you better believe it.
We're hanging out there last night getting ready for the game.
I'm always on that website, you better believe. All right, chance to take the lead here for Driscoll. First time in a ball game. Here is Spychalski. Two out. Runners on first and third. Gasparri on third. Chris Kuhns on first. And Jordan Roth laboring to get out of the inning against the 8th batter this inning. Nice curveball.
He's relied a little too much, though, Mike, on his breaking stuff. As you look, it's Eddie Spychalski, 453 hitter, driven in 38 on the season. You've got to use your fastball more and climb the ladder, force guys to maybe go after a pitch that they don't like that has good velocity.
Runner goes from thirst, they throw down. Not nearly in time. Gasparri did not come home.
Boy, that cost Driscoll an opportunity. He really had a chance to score.
I thought Gasparri was set up to come home.
There's another high floating breaking ball. There's a tough throw to handle. Bensko can't come up with it. He slips, and Gasparri over at third really wasn't paying attention. You've got to break on that and come a few feet down the line and then make a play.
1-1 pitch outside corner, 1-2. Spychalski hit by a pitch and walked, so he hasn't been up officially this game. There is Rich Gasparri at third. Chris Kuhns at second. Roth ahead on the count. Line shot. Bensko. And Spychalski tripped over first base. But no further damage as Bensko throws him out 6-3. 3 runs, 2 hits, no errors. It's all tied at 5. Driscoll with 3 runs in the bottom of the inning. We go to the 5th now, all tied at 5, and leading off for Pleasant Plains will be the shortstop, Dusty Bensko. And you only have to go back a couple of innings to see what Bensko did last time with the bases loaded.
He turned on it in a big, big way.
Gone.
And get out.
Just took off like a shot.
Just to the left of the 350 sign. That ball was smoked for a grand slam.
All right, new pitcher coming in for Driscoll, Matt Zaleski. Zaleski with a 7-0 record.
Now he only has 7 innings left in him. He pitched 2 innings earlier today. He has 7 innings left. And because he's not the starting pitcher, if the game goes to extra innings, he would have to come out.
So Spychalski went 4 innings, gave up 5 runs, 6 hits, struck out 3. And by my count, didn't walk anybody.
Your count is accurate.
Is that right?
No walks.
I don't have any WWs down here on my scorecard.
Did have a couple of HBPs, though.
Again, Driscoll. Look out. What more can this guy do? This one clears the 350. First pitch.
That ball was absolutely smoked. He takes the slow trot around the bases. Wow, did he turn on that one.
This is an athlete, ladies and gentlemen. You are seeing something special here tonight. Five runs batted in, two home runs. This is a young man who led his basketball team in scoring. He was All-State in a semifinal, three overtime victory. He had 32 points, including 17 for 17 from the free throw line, and he has done every bit as much here on the baseball diamond. Look at this, David.
That ball is right on the outer portion of the plate, and he turns on it. Look at the bat speed. As soon as he hit it, he turns to the bench and says,
I called it. Oh, my.
What's up? That ball is gone.
That's in the custard shop. And here's a shot by Roth, but right there is Matt Butler. That ball also hit on the nose, but right at the center fielder.
Wow. You know, the grand slam was impressive because he smoked it. This one, he absolutely drove out of the ballpark. Wow.
Right over the 350 sign. First pitch. He knew Zaleski would throw him a fastball. And here's Albsmeyer. Hits this one in the gap, but lots of room, lots of time for Butler.
I would
so
bet
three pitches, two outs, and a blast.
That ball was very close to 400, 410. That ball was way out. You can watch the reaction of the left fielder. The ball jumped off the bat, and he really never moved. He just looked up and said, oh, no.
He just turned around and bye-bye. Oh. Two out now, Ryan Nelson. One for two, flied out last at bat. So Pleasant Plains has the lead back at 6-5. Right back through the middle, Hernandez. Seppi fields it smoothly. So, a run, a hit, another home run for Dusty Driscoll. And Pleasant Plains has got the lead 6-5 at the 4.5. Bottom of the fifth inning, Mike Lederman, David Kaplan, Jim Corno Jr., our Fox Sportsnet crew. Pleasant Plains getting the lead back on a mammoth home run by Dusty Driscoll. And Jordan Roth goes back to work here against the catcher, left-handed hitting Jeremy Fisher. There is Roth. Giving up six hits and five runs. Gets a strike over first pitch here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Fisher 0 for 2, fly out, ground out. Well, Driscoll had Roth on the ropes last inning, but he managed to get that third out. Here's one pop by third base. Well in the seats for Needham. Pleasant Plains, five in the third, highlighted by a grand slam by Driscoll. Then one more, the solo homer in the fifth for six. Two in the second, three in the fourth for Driscoll. Here they are, bottom of the fifth, trailing by a run. And there's one smoke down the right field line.
Fair ball.
And it's a fair ball in the corner. And it'll be a stand-up double for, well, he really slid into second with what should have been a stand-up double. But Fisher, who was out on a bang-bang play to kill a rally, now leads off with a double, and it'll be a runner for him. And that is Scott Carlson. Carlson, fastest man on the team, is going to pinch run. So a big opening two-bagger for Jeremy Fisher, his 16th double.
That ball just wasn't high enough to get out. It reaches the wall. I mean, he really pulls this ball down the line. You can see it's fair. And smoked off the wall.
Back to live as the DH, Brett Lettenberger, takes ball one. That was a real mammoth shot. The hardest ball certainly hit by Driscoll all night. And Scott Carlson is the runner on second base. There's a strike, 1-1. Good ball game tonight. Class A championship. Cuss will bring you the Class AA as well. That David and I will be up there. Beautiful Kane County.
Absolutely. Elstrom Stadium.
That's it. Jim Corno Jr. will be there too, he reminds us. And there's a shot down the left field line, giving pursuit, fouled into the bullpen. Nobody out, tying run on second base for Driscoll. Lettenberger the DH up there, and the Syrix to follow. Tim, then Chris. Another good play, but no. Throw to third, not in time. Once again, Needham made the block, but the ball got away from him, and the speedy Carlson took off immediately.
Well, now what you want to do as a hitter, it's a 2-2 count. If you get something you can at least get the bat on, you've got to hit it to the right side, or you've got to hit that thing up the middle.
And here is Dave Greer, as we'll take a look at the replay. Dave Greer going out to the mound and may make a change here. He is taking raw. There you see the play at third base. And Roth will come out. And let's see who's going to come in.
Bensko went seven innings earlier today. Would they bring him back? He's got two left in his arm.
There's Roth. Get all the changes. Roth will go over to first. And Matt Clark is going to come in. Clark pitched a complete game victory in the quarterfinal. Matt Clark on the year, 12-0, 1.88 earned run average, 46 hits, only 18 earned runs, 94 strikeouts. So we'll tell you more about Matt Clark and bring you back to the action right after this. Stay tuned. There's a discussion on the mound around Matt Clark. Matt Clark, 6'3", 230-pounder, big guy. Throws in the high 80s, David, and pitched a complete game in the quarterfinals, giving up eight hits against Mendota in a tight 4-3 win. Gave up those three runs in the first couple of innings and settled down and pitched shutout ball the rest of the way. Hello.
That's what it's all about. You father bet. And son hanging out at a baseball game on a beautiful summer evening. I think June is my favorite month. Just a great month.
Dare we say that it's busting out all over, huh?
June is busting out all over, absolutely.
All right. Well, Dave Greer made the switch with a 2-0 count, so that is what Clark inherits on the DH, Lettenberger. And this one into right field. Nelson there. Runner tags. Here's the throw.
Well,
and the ball game is tied. They cut it off. It wasn't going to get there anyway, but... Scott Carlson comes in to score the tying run.
I think they had a play at the plate, Michael.
Yeah.
I really do.
Okay.
Coach Greer just said, why did you cut the ball? I don't know if anybody called it. It's short right field. He gets off a pretty good throw.
See where the runner is.
Yeah. Would have been close. It would have been bang, bang. And the relay throw, airmail. You see the coach in the background, hands on his head. No, why did you cut it?
So the line on Roth is complete. Four innings plus, six runs, seven hits. Six hits, rather. Struck out three. And gave up one walk. So it is Clark's game now to win or lose, and he is facing Tim Syrak. Syrak.
Single and a triple tonight. That triple was an outstanding piece of hitting. A low pitch, he went down and got, and he pulled it down the right field line.
Well, One away, base is empty. 6-6 ball game here in the Class A championship. Roth at first base having a problem, and Clark gets over in time.
Nice job by Clark to cover the bag.
That's what you were talking about, running up the line, getting off the mound and breaking and making the play that you don't think you're going to have to make.
The way that that's supposed to be played, you sprint on a direct line right to the baseline, you turn up and you run along the baseline, and you give your first baseman a big target, and you see how he comes over. Really doesn't get to the line, but he gives enough of a target to make the play.
That one in the dirt. One ball count on Chris Sirak. Again, they're identical twins. And sophomores. The 1-0. Low ball two.
State championship on the line. We're already in the fifth. Bottom half of the frame and a tie ball game.
Well, it's been a perfect night. Can you ask for anything more? Here's the 2-0. Maybe outside, maybe a little low. You know, he's got that build of another Clark. Pitched pretty well for the Cubs a while ago. A little Mark Clark in it.
Yep. No? Big body. And it's setting up that Dusty Bensko could be coming to the plate in the seventh with a tie ball game.
There you see the defensive alignment. Big gap in right center field. You see the outfielder shifting over now with a 3-1 count on Chris Sirak. Foul that one into the crowd behind first base.
Tell you what, if he hits one to right center, to left center, he can run all day.
There's a good look at Chris Sirak. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Tying run is in. And just outside, ball four. First base on balls. Given up by Matt Clark. And here is the shortstop. Seppi Hernandez hit by a pitch last time, later came around to score. 0 for 1 officially here, Seppi. Clark, by the way, going to go to Illinois State on a baseball scholarship. There goes the runner. And they play hit and run. Foul down the right field line.
There's Dave Greer.
Yeah, 11th season at the helm. Didn't play much himself in college, but boy, has he developed a nice team. And he's had these kids in elementary school, many of them. As the ball gets by on the pickoff, here we go again. And down to second base goes Chris Sirak.
Again, you have to think about where you're throwing and what you're going to do with it. Why take the chance? You had no chance to pick this base runner off, no matter if that ball got over there at 100 miles an hour.
Error charged on Clark, the first error for Pleasant Plains. There you see it.
I mean, even if the ball is there, the runner didn't even have to dive to get back. He was in standing. Now you give Driscoll a chance with two outs to have a runner in scoring position.
Dave Greer telling his infielders to discuss things. And we're going to get a pinch runner. Mike Joyce. Mike Joyce, 6'2" junior. And he will run for Sirak, for Chris Sirak. Late in the ball game here in the bottom of the fifth inning. All tied at six.
Good look at the powerful Jeff Sefcik.
Yes, sirree.
Big strong guy.
And funny.
He is hilarious.
No balls, one strike, and again, time called. Mike Joyce leads off second. Two men out, all tied at six. Championship game, and there's almost hit. Seppi again. He didn't move any faster to get out of that one. Well, that one didn't want to hit him.
Take a look at Sefcik. He is on his guys at every opportunity. Very, very intense, demanding coach, very devoted.
1-1 pitch. Check swing, could be trouble, but camping under it, getting there, Ryan Nelson. But Driscoll comes up with a run. They get a hit. There was an error, one left. We're all tied at six, going to the sixth. There's part of the atmosphere here at Springfield as the train runs by right field of a 6-6 tie in the Class A championship. Mike Lederman, David Kaplan.
That's the bullpen car.
And, yeah. It is wonderful. What a scene. Meanwhile, here's DeRocco. Hits one into left field. Coming on. Fair ball. Bouncing right in front of Tim Cirac. So DeRocco. Gets on and very quickly Jeff Sefcik is on the mound, and it looks like he's going to make a switch as this ball falls just inside the line.
That's the beauty of having six umpires right on top of the play.
Thought Sefcik had signaled. There is activity in the bullpen. As Zaleski is in his second inning of work, he gave up that monster home run to Bensko, his first pitch as he came in, and he will stay. To face the bottom of the order, Circo, and
four more hitters, the
number
Dusty
nine spot. Yeah,
Bensko.
The number nine spot. Aaron Circo. Clark will hit in the number nine spot. To the right side. And the sacrifice works. And here is Matt Clark getting his first at-bat. Clark hasn't been up much. Only 28 at-bats, but he's got 14 hits and five ribbies. So I don't know if his mom's keeping the stats, but we know one thing. Dusty's mom isn't lying. He's looked like a 600 hitter. Here's
wow.
Clark with a runner on second base.
Yeah,
big cut.
Doesn't matter if Dusty's mom or whoever keeps the book.
Pillsbury
he's a 660
Doughboy
hitter.
Can keep the stats. This guy is amazing. Strike. Sefcik's coming out again. I wonder what prompted that. Now Jeff calls all the pitches. We see Chris Kuhns and the rest of the infield around Matt Zaleski and Jeff Sefcik. And I wonder what this could be. Threw a strike.
I don't know if he missed a call on what pitch he wanted.
He's going to make a change. So Zaleski comes out with an 0-1 count. And the call to the bullpen. All right, we'll bring you the information on the new pitcher right after this. We're in a 6-6 tie in the top of the sixth inning. Well, we'd like to tell you our producer and director tonight is the one, the only, the ever popular Jim Corno Jr. Sam Poulos, our graphics coordinator. And our facilities manager, Moheen Ramsey, the pride of Central Canada. Executive producer, the pride of Downers Grove. Handsome Dan Lafferty.
He pay you to say that?
No, I'm totally spontaneous. Here is Glenn Camas, the winning pitcher in the semifinal, pitched five innings and pitched well. Camas, who his given name is Christopher goes by Glenn.
Or C. Glenn Camus.
C. Glenn. It's like G. Gordon Liddy? I don't think so. And that's a quick strike, too.
He throws gas. Sit back and enjoy this, because he throws heat.
8-1 on the season, ERA of 1.37. And that's it. Bye-bye. Mr. Clark took two cuts.
Blows you away. Blows you away.
Well, there's Camus. He's got a blister that he picked up in the semifinal. Doesn't seem to be bothering him, Dave.
No, he just rears back, and that is just boom, by you. Gone. I mean, that is exactly what he's brought in to do. Throw strikes. That's just heat. That's
and Bo Gum is finding that out.
That's 87 to 90 range.
Gum, 1-for-3, but he's been on base all three times. Two errors, last two times up. One by the second baseman, one by the third. And he has scored a run. Runner on second base, the lead runner, 6-6 tie. Pleasant Plains and Driscoll, the Class A championship being decided here, and it is going down to the final inning and maybe more. So we've seen both coaches take pitchers out in the middle of a count. Gum now ahead on the count, 2-1. Gum, a good hitter, very fast, decent speed at second with DiRocco. Opposite way, base hit. Around third, here comes the throw. Here comes DiRocco, and he is out. What a play by the catcher, Fisher. Jeremy Fisher picked that ball out of the air and came down on the tag in one fell swoop. What a play.
Well, I'm just stunned,
absolutely.
One, that he came up with it, and two, that he was able to make the play. Dave Greer is livid.
Kanders in right field threw a strike, maybe a little high, but what a play. We'll show you this again. Meanwhile, Greer and the home plate umpire are going at it. Brad Stearns and Greer, watch this. Here's the play. There's the catch. Turns around. Yeah, he tagged him. You bet. He's out.
He is out. That's a heck of a play.
He didn't know he tagged him, but look at the throw here by Kanders.
It's all or nothing. Now watch this.
He got him. If he did, now the umpire was screened there, but if he tagged him, it was behind the back. Let's see if we can see it. Because the catcher has his back to the runner as the ball comes in.
All right, now he's got the ball.
Well, maybe right there.
No, he got him on the leg. It looks like the other angle I'd love to see again, because here comes the throw. Now watch. He blocks him there with the leg. The leg comes up. I think he got it. I think he got it.
All right. No runs. And we go to the bottom of the sixth. And we're tied at six.
That's a bang-bang play.
All right. Getting down to crunch time. We'll be back with more. Pleasant Plains and Driscoll. All tied at six. All right, bottom half of the sixth inning. Driscoll at bat and a 6-6 tie.
I'll tell you what, the place is still buzzing on that throw, catch, and tag. What a great play, and we watched it again, and I'm telling you, it's close, but I think he got it.
Here's Butler. He takes a strike.
And the umpire's right there. He's right on top of the play. It's bang, bang.
Matt Butler, fly ball to center, a ground out and a strikeout, three trips. He's overdue. And that one's low, 2-1. Matt Clark on the mound for his second inning of work. Here's the 2-1.
Good movement on the fastball. Nice pitch.
So I told you, Clark's a big guy, 235 pounds. 2-2. On deck is Gasparri. Kuhn's to follow. Fouled it back. Still 3-2.
That will be one of the plays that people will talk about for a long time around these two programs. Jeremy Fisher gets a huge, huge pat on the back from Jeff Sefcik.
And again, a foul ball. Butler staying alive. Matt only 5'8", 175, but hitting nearly 500 coming into this one. 0 for 3 tonight. Two. And a bad hop over the head of Dusty Bensko. Wow. That looked like a tailor-made chance and just took off higher than Arvydas Sabonis.
I remember when Ryan Sandberg had that in the 84 playoffs at San Diego in the deciding game five. Same type thing. It just hit something on the infield and boom.
Wow. So the lead man on. First hit for Butler, and here is Gasparri, and Gasparri with two hits tonight already in three trips. Butler certainly a threat to go in a 6-6 ball game.
Now, Jeff Sefcik, not a manager head coach that likes to do a lot of bunting early in innings with nobody out, but at this stage of the game, state championship on the line, does he ascribe to that theory? We'll find out.
Well, DiRocco is playing in on the grass, anticipating the bunt. Gasparri shows bunt and pulls back but takes the strike. Clark, as we told you, headed for Illinois State. There is Sefcik. Give him the signs. Clark keeping the runner close. Jordan Roth, the starting pitcher there, now playing first base. No balls, one strike. Nobody out. Pleasant Plains and Driscoll Catholic all tied at six. Doesn't get that bunt down. It's 0-2. I don't know what kind of sign he's looking for now. If Jeff wants him to bunt with two strikes, not after those two attempts, you'd doubt it. Gasparri can handle the bat. Nine runs batted in, 347 on the season.
Surprised more guys don't choke up on the bat more. They're all holding it down at the knob.
Pitch out at 0-2. Runner wasn't going.
You're facing a Division I pitcher, a guy with really good stuff. You'd think at 0-2, you'd choke up on
right.
the bat.
Stay alive. 6-9-1 for Pleasant Plains. 6-7-3 for Driscoll. Again, the 1-2. And Gasparri, delayed reaction. That pitch was just right down the middle. Gasparri realized he couldn't pull the trigger.
Watch this. Wow. He's looking fastball, and he throws him off speed. And this is just filthy.
Go.
Look at that. Oh. Boom. Buckle the knees. Goodbye. Great pitch. That is nasty.
Chris Kuhns, as the crowd starts to rumble the seats. Good support for both schools. We told you Pleasant Plains, boy, they're packing the right field side. And folks from Addison have come down from Chicago area, that 2.5 hour trip. A little bit longer than the Pleasant Plains folks had to come by, maybe by about 2 hours. Kuhns takes an inside pitch over the corner, strike one. Boy, this has been a good ball game.
Outstanding. Had drama in a number of ways. Bensko, two right. home runs, the play at the plate.
Yeah, there's been a lot of sloppy play here, but this is a championship situation. We're tied. We've seen some tremendous plays. That play at the plate, they're going to be talking about for quite some time.
Oh, yeah.
Especially if Driscoll wins it.
I got to think he may have a stolen base opportunity here.
0-1, there he goes. And right through the hole, doing a beautiful bit of hit and run. And first and third now for Driscoll, and one man away. Right through the empty shortstop vacated hole. Chris Kuhn's just bounced one, sending the runner Butler to third.
You can't play it any better than that. That's exactly how you play hit and run baseball.
And here is, there you see, no question about it, with the play in front of him, the runner is easily going to make third base. And Scott Carlson's going to come in, and he's going to run. For Chris Kuhns. And here is Spychalski, who started this game, as you look at Jeff Sefcik. Good opportunity here for Driscoll in the bottom of the sixth inning.
Look at the average, 453.
The team hits 420.
It's incredible.
Well, actually, that's Pleasant Plains hits 420. Driscoll only hits 370.
You look at the ERAs. Team ERA for Pleasant Plains, 271. And for Driscoll, 215. I mean, those are just lights out earned run averages.
One out, runners on first and third, and a good pitch. Strike one to Spychalski. Spychalski scored a run, hit by a pitch, walked, grounded to the shortstop. So he hasn't really gotten a hold of one.
There goes the runner
from first, and they throw. And the shortstop comes in, Bensko, to cut the ball off in case the runner from third had any idea of scoring. Stolen base. This time Carlson goes in, but they hold the runner at third. So now, with first base open, there you see the catcher Ryan Needham looking to the bench for instructions. And Dave Greer has come out, moving his defense around, and sends Needham out to talk to the pitcher. Nobody working in the bullpen, either bullpen, but we'll have a little conference here. If you're just joining us, Driscoll with two in the second, Pleasant Plains. Grand slam by Dusty Bensko in the third. Big part of a five-run inning. Driscoll coming back with three in the fourth. Each team got a run in the fifth. So we're all tied at six. But the run that did not score was the topic of conversation, a close play at the plate. And Driscoll nailed the Pleasant Plains runner to keep the score at six. Now, one out, second and third for Driscoll. Straight up to center. Adds Meyer, and the lead run will score. So Spychalski breaks the tie with a sacrifice fly. Runner at second holds up.
Does his job. He puts the ball in the air deep enough. Good wheels at third.
Here's the pitch from Clark.
Does a nice piece of hitting. You see him go down and get it, and he pops it up to shallow center field. Center fielder really did not do a very good job at setting himself to catch the ball and make the throw.
Meanwhile, with Fisher up, I believe they gave him the intentional. And Fisher's at first base, so the runner's now at first and second. And here's the designated hitter who, last time up, Lettenberger, a sacrifice fly, brought in a run.
A Now watch this. Here comes the throw. Now watch the first baseman. Pretends he's got it. See if he can maybe fool a runner off the bag, but no, nothing.
No balls, one strike, the count on Brett Lettenberger. There goes the runner, and both runners, and the pitch fouled off. Runners breaking from both bases.
I don't think he fouled it. I think they're going to call that one in the dirt, a swing, and both runners move up.
I thought he made the motion. No, okay, both runners are up a base, so well, it's double steal.
See the runner going in the screen, and no, did not touch it. Ball in the dirt.
So it's a double steal. Two runners in scoring position here. Driscoll with a chance to break things wide open. Although we hesitate to say that, knowing the way this game has gone. And this will bring in two. One run is home. Runner around third coming in to score. There's going to be a play, but Bensko held the ball. Not Bensko, the first baseman held the ball. And two runs come in on the single to center field.
Roth couldn't get the ball out of his glove. I think he was so stunned to see the base runner coming, who would have been out by 30 feet.
Oh, it wasn't even a question. Runner on second had to hold up to see if that ball was going to be caught.
There's the base hit to center. Center fielder misplays it. Still gets off a pretty strong throw.
There's Roth.
And Roth looks and goes, oh my God.
Just let it go. Three RBIs. And just like that, it's a three-run lead for Driscoll.
Jeff Sefcik there, pumping his fist, fired up on that second run score.
So now Driscoll with a three-run lead, 9-6. Tim Cyrak up.
Well, Matt Clark has pitched better than the result right now.
1-0 to Tim Cyrak. And there goes the runner again, and the ball gets by. And they're just running with abandon now. Needham couldn't make a play, probably couldn't have had him even if the ball had come up. Evening. Tim Cyrak, 2-for-3. A big triple down the right field line, later came around to score. The 2-0. Squid foul by third base. Looking ahead to the top of the seventh. We will see Mr. Bensko. Two balls, one strike, two outs. Base still has a play. And the ball pulled the first baseman off, so runner safe and first and third. Roth pulled off the base by the throw after DeRocco kicked it. Still had time.
Call it an error five.
E5 for DeRocco.
Ball smoked toward third, cannot come up with it, and then he's late with the throw.
Dave Greer is coming out. Three runs in this inning. Greer is talking to DeRocco. Jess had, remember, been hit a couple of times. And I think wants to see if he's okay. He's talking to Bernard, the umpire. Oh, to Brad Stearns. They're just chatting. Remember, it's only a game, right?
Only a game. But boy, we take it seriously sometimes.
But you can see there were smiles there on the faces of both the umpire and the coach. And here is Chris Sirak. A single and a walk in three trips. Runners on first and third. Three-run lead for Driscoll. Matt Clark came on in the fifth, got out of that, but has run into all sorts of trouble here in the sixth, and much of it has not been his own making. And a delayed steal as the runner just takes off and walks to second base. Tim Sirak, as Clark just wasn't paying any attention to him. And now, what's going on here? They're giving first base.
Take intentional walk.
And they call it the intentional walk. Don't have to throw the wide ones. So Chris Sirak goes down to first. And Seppi Hernandez has the bases loaded, two out, and a three-run lead.
Well, he can break this thing wide open with a base hit.
Foul down the first baseline.
By the way,
nice play by Steve DeTomo.
Those of you watching at home, Bensko will bat in the seventh.
Oh, yes, he
will. Second hitter in the inning.
You bet.
Well, unless they come up with a three-run home run with two batters, he cannot tie the game. He's already hit two. If you've missed it, he hit a grand slam and then a mammoth solo shot about 400 feet to left center.
Kastner, Bensko, and Roth. The three hitters coming up for Pleasant Plains in the top of what is scheduled to be the final inning. And Seppi goes strike two. Well, you hear the Driscoll fans, they want more. No balls, two strikes. Clark's pitch. And he steps on the plate as the ball is in the dirt. So Needham made the play he had to make. But three runs come across on one, two, three hits. Go to the top of the seventh. 9-6, Driscoll. Chance for Pleasant Plains, trailing by three, Tyler Kastner.
1-1 count on him now.
Takes a strike after a ball. Kastner will be followed by Bensko and then Jordan Roth. Pleasant Plains needs a rally. And there's a base hit.
And the man will bat with a man on.
Hit number 10 for Pleasant Plains.
Big night for Dusty Bensko. 2 for 3, a grand slam, and a solo home run. Let me tell you.
Oh,
that was a major league home run, the second one.
He doesn't have to do anything else to convince me, but certainly he still finds his team on a short end of a 9-6 score. Grand slam home run, a solo shot. Conference at the mound. Well, what do you do? How do you pitch to this guy?
All right, here we go. This is earlier tonight.
Yeah, now he's batting .658, okay. His batting average went down. This is the grand slam. This is back in the second, in the third, rather. And then.
Well, look at this one. Look at him look at the bench. He looks over and says, goodbye. That ball smoked.
Well, here he is facing Glenn Camas. Throw to first, nothing doing.
I'll tell you what, of all the pitchers that we've watched this weekend, Camas seems to have the most complete package of stuff and understanding how to pitch, mechanics, the whole thing, no pitch.
Time called as the delivery made, so no pitch.
Too many guys get away from throwing heat. They have live arms. They throw mid-80s. Some guys here are hitting 91, 92 on the gun. Here's a kid that the scouts are telling me touches 90. That's a tough pitch to hit.
Kastner, runner on first. Three runs in the bottom of the sixth. Driscoll leading by three. Bensko takes it high. The 1-0. 2-0.
Well, they haven't given him anything here yet. He likes that fastball away. Gets such quick wrist through the zone.
I really don't understand why Camas is working on the runner at first. That run doesn't mean anything. We've seen what can happen with those errant throws. There's a strike.
Good pitch, fastball in the corner.
2-1. Pleasant Plains looking for its first championship. Driscoll for its fourth. Runner bluffs does not go, and we're even at 2-2.
Another tough pitch to hit. Painted the black on the inside corner. Now the money ball, 2-2 count.
And he got him.
Handcuffed him.
Great pitch right on the inside.
You can't hit that
pitch. Nothing, he just was tied up, completely tied up.
Buddy, this kid knows how to pitch. Look where this pitch is. Right in on the hands. It's gonna be rung up for strike three. He's got nothing he can do with it. That's a beautiful piece of pitching.
Here's Jordan Roth, starting pitcher, now first baseman. He's gonna talk to Dave Greer with one out, a runner on. He's 0-3.
We've been handed our all-tournament team ballot.
And Jeff Sefcik comes out to say something.
And they have the winners of the all-tournament team by position.
Okay.
So we'll see if we can get to these. Chris Kuhns of Addison Driscoll is your first baseman. James Potter Eldorado at second. Ted Rowe of Dunlap is your third baseman. Greg, I believe it's Einhorn,
yeah.
Of Teutopolis is your shortstop.
Strike one to Jordan Roth.
Justin McKinney, Johnny King, Tim Sirak make up the outfield. McKinney from Eldorado, King from Teutopolis.
There's a name missing.
Tim Sirak, Addison Driscoll. Catcher is Jeremy Fisher from Driscoll. Your DH, Bo Gum of Pleasant Plains.
There's a name missing.
Your pitcher, Matt Clark, Pleasant Plains. Pitcher, Matt Zaleski of Driscoll. And your MVP of the tournament.
Uh-huh.
Dusty Bensko.
0-2. To the hole, cut off by the third baseman. He'll go the short way and throw it away. Sirak threw the ball away. Ball into right field, and they've got runners on first and third as Sirak just tried to be too careful. And it's the fourth error of the night for Driscoll, and lo and behold, the tying run is at the plate.
That makes pretty good pitch.
Well, the normally sure-handed Chris Sirak.
He just throws it away.
Yeah.
Looks down and says, how could I do that?
So, runners at first and third, tying run at the plate in the presence of center fielder Joe Albsmeyer. Albsmeyer so far 0-3 with a strikeout, a ground out, and a fly out to center. Good breaking pitch, strike one. Albsmeyer, a sophomore, only 5'8", but he's hitting .412 with two homers, 24 ribbies. Inside pitch, but it was really off.
Fouled
the
it off
batter,
his leg.
Yeah.
That one stings.
Suck it up right now. See this one, he just...
Ouch.
Oh, right off the shin.
Ouch.
Oh.
That hurts.
No balls, two strikes. On center fielder, Joe Albsmeyer. What's so interesting about this Pleasant Plains team is we've been telling you only two seniors really play. Everybody else will be back, including Bensko for starters, DeRocco, Kastner, Gum. Well, the first base umpire now Mike Caskey may have ejected someone, or a camera lens fell. Oh boy.
Those are not cheap.
No, and you just want to crawl under that chair.
Well, I certainly hope my photo editor wasn't watching the game tonight. Because that $2,000 lens is not in good condition.
Here's the 0-2 pitch. Check out the 1-2 pitch, now 2-2.
The call home.
Oh, boy.
Boss, what'd you think of the game then? Oh, I was out to dinner. I didn't get to see it. Oh, good.
Uh-huh. Here's the 2-2. Foul back behind third base.
Nice catch by the fan on the ricochet.
On deck is Ryan Nelson, so middle of the order. Here's Albsmeyer, the number 5 hitter. 2-2. Base knock.
And they've got life. Base knock, it's a 9-7 game. And the go-ahead run comes to the plate.
Kastner scores. Roth moves to second. And here is Ryan Nelson, as you see, a solid hit. Threw short into left field. So here is Ryan Nelson, a single and 3 trips. It is now a 9-7 ball game. Ball one. Jester Rocco on deck. Camas trying to nail it down. Good pitch for a strike. 1-1. Two and one. Nelson again, one of only 2 seniors who really play.
See runners at first and second, 2-run ball game. Pleasant Plains has out hit Driscoll 11-8, 4 Driscoll errors, but they lead it 9-7.
Roth on second, Albsmeyer on first. Back to the box, Camas still has the play. 2 out. Well, again, Camas certainly had a play at third, but couldn't come up with the ball cleanly.
Well, he falls off toward the first base side. He steps back, knocks it down, and then presence of mind stays with it, guns him out at first. And here's DiRocco. Been banged up a little bit in the tournament. Took one off the head.
Yeah. His power is to right center. He'll go the opposite way. He's got the tying runs in scoring position. 2 out. Championship on the line here. Camas deals. Almost hit him.
Breaking ball inside.
1-0. DiRocco, single to right, single to left, and 3 trips to the plate. 2 runners leading away.
There's your base hit.
Here comes one run. Sarek winds up. Not a chance. We're tied at 9.
DiRocco, he struggled a little bit defensively tonight, comes up with a huge hit. The biggest hit of his young life, base hit to left, state championship on the line, and we're tied at 9.
Oh my, what more can you ask? Here's Camas's pitch. No doubt about it. Now Sirik here can't field it cleanly. Several times Driscoll tonight has not come up with the ball cleanly. Now looking for the lead. Aaron Cerco with a single. Three runs, 3 hits. Tied the ball game up. Nothing 2, two outs. You see the score. Well, it's a nice night, but it's been a great game. Nobody wants to go home. Glenn Camas, the pitcher, came on, seemed to be in total control last inning, has had big problems here in the seventh. Couldn't hold the 3-0 lead, but defensively, of course, he didn't have a lot of help. Fouled back, he's still alive.
0-2 count. I was talking with Fergie Jenkins last summer. He came into the All-Century team with the Cubs. The catcher takes one right off the mask.
There he goes, watch
foul.
Fisher here. We'll get back to the story, but watch Fisher. Oh,
the umpire got it too. And Fergie was saying.
Well, let's hold for the pitch, and there's a base hit into right field. On his way to third as the ball goes through. Coming around third. Here comes the throw. And the lead run scores. Unbelievable.
Pleasant Plains is going nuts. They've scored four in the inning, and that's just a poorly played ball in right field.
See how they rule it. The ball was hit. Certainly it was a single. But Kenders, who made that outstanding throw an inning ago, that's Spychowski out there. Spychowski's out there now.
This ball's broke. This ball is smoked. Good piece of hitting. Just doesn't get over in time to cut it off.
So call it a double. And Clark is hit. Well, the wheels seem to be falling off for Driscoll.
We'll get a runner for him now. Courtesy runner.
You know, we got a check. I thought that was Kenders and Wright. It's Spychowski. Maybe it was Spychowski who made that throw that nailed the runner at the plate.
I think it was Kenders, but I can't be sure.
Well, here is Bo Gum, and he's got a chance to pad the lead. It's 10-9 with a four-run seventh inning against Glenn Camas.
Anyway, what I was going to tell you was Fergie Jenkins was saying when he pitched for Leo DeRocher, if a ball was even fouled off on 0-2, you were fine. He said Leo's philosophy was on 0-2, you give nothing to hit. Absolutely don't come near the
plate. Oh, the pitcher was fine.
Pitcher's fine, yeah. If the ball's even fouled off. He said we learned to waste one quickly.
Ninth man to come up, Bo Gum. Dave Greer, he's getting more camera time than Yasmin Bleeth, I think, tonight. Here's Bo. But he has been all over the place. Nah. There's Bo. What a game. This has just been one of the most entertaining, maybe not the best played game you'll ever see, but certainly it has had everything.
Well, I would not have expected Camas to give up four here.
That certainly has been the best directed. We've just voted there. Well, he's leaving him in there. He's really gone through most of the staff.
Yeah, he's got nobody warming up.
They had a lot of depth at Driscoll. They had four or five pitchers who can pitch, and they've all been there. Four or five pitchers every team, a lot of teams would like to have. Going to get a pinch runner here. Gibbs Glisson, number eight. Zirko will come out. So Gibbs Glisson, a junior, 165-pound, 5'9 junior, is on second base. Is that Clark on at first? They put a runner in for him. There's another base hit into center field. Check it. Spoke too soon. Butler, with that good range, makes the catch, but nine men come to the plate, and four of them score. So, we'll go to the bottom of the seventh, trailing by one. Driscoll will have a chance. Well, a couple of heavyweights going at it. Take that, no take that. Driscoll with three in the sixth. It should be three in the sixth. And then Pleasant Plains coming back with four in the seventh. So we are Pleasant Plains protecting a one-run lead. Now, the way things are going, that's about as sure as what? Insert your own metaphor here, but let's say it's a little shaky, right, the way things have been.
Now, the question is, if they get in trouble, would they bring Dusty Bensko in? He's got two innings left.
Matt Butler, top of the order, leading it off, 1-for-4. Butler came in nearly 500. That's where he is. Matt Clark, the pitcher. Second baseman, tough play. Beats it out.
Leadoff man is on.
Here we go again. Circa to his right, but had a long throw and bounced at the first base. Butler, very fleet of foot, was going to beat it anyway. Rich Gaspari now with the tying run on first. What else could possibly happen?
Don't say that.
We've seen it all. Kuhn's on deck. Strike one. Gaspari, two hits and four trips. Strike out and a fly to right. He's got two ribbies. Driscoll down by a run. There goes the runner. Hit and run goes right through the hole. Second baseman makes the play nicely. Over to Roth at first. Again, the pitch is slow covering, but Roth was able to cover and get back. So a 4-3, and the runner moves up.
Well, hit and run's on. He's got to go down and get it. He finds a breaking ball, slaps it to the right side, and just barely is nipped at first.
All right, wow. Well, here is Chris Kuhns, the big stick, home run leader. Last time up, got his first hit of the night. Later came around to score and has a chance here to tie things once again or do one better. You ready for a walk-off?
Yeah, walk-off home run to win it.
Oh, my.
I think that would be neat. I'm sure Coach Greer will say,
no, he's not.
Neat.
No.
But it would be an interesting thing to see.
Driscoll trailing 10-9. Pleasant Plains looking for that doubleheader win, basketball and baseball. Right now they could care less about basketball.
I just like the drama.
Good pitch, breaking ball away.
He's got great form, really follows through and finishes, drives with his legs, real good looking pitch. He'll play again at Illinois State.
The 0-1. Again taking something off. Chalski on deck. One out. Runner on second. 10-9. Pleasant Plains. Driscoll with a threat to tie. Bottom half of the seventh inning. The scheduled last inning. The 0-2.
Good waste pitch.
Matt Clark came on in the fifth inning with a 2-0 count, got the batter, has held him pretty much. Well, then there was the sixth inning. Gave up three runs. Trying to nail it down here. Boy, is that easier said than done, the way this game's gone. One ball, two strikes. There is Clark, ISU bound, but he's got a little unfinished business here in his last game as a high schooler. One, two. Need him once again. Making the play.
He's been rock solid behind the plate.
And now from 0-2, we go full to 3-2. You know, we just looked at the tape back there, that play that seemed so long ago where the Pleasant Plains runner was thrown out at the plate. Spychalski made that throw.
Was it Spychalski?
Yeah, that's what we're told. So we got to give credit where credit is due. Protecting the plate.
That was a great throw.
Wow. That's worth seeing again. And the highlights from this game, incredible.
Outstanding. Got a grand slam. Another home run, both by Bensko. The play at the plate.
Back and forth. So 3-2 here, runner on second base. Matt Butler with the tying run. Pitch to Kuhns. Good at bat, just spoiling the ones he doesn't like. There's the big gap in right center field. Between Albsmeyer and Nelson.
Yeah, you smoke one to deep right center, and you probably have a walk-off inside the park home
yeah,
run.
That's right. Payoff pitch. Now the winning run is on first base.
And the man that made the throw, the starting pitcher tonight, Eddie Spychalski, will come to the plate.
Spychalski is a hitter. Nothing for two, hit by a pitch and walked. Has an RBI with a sacrifice fly. Actually, he's 0-for-1. We're going to have a pinch runner here. Scott Carlson's going to make a living running, I think. Oh, that's number 28. It's not Carlson. We're going to check at Steve McHouston again. McHouston and Carlson have been the DRs, if you will, the designated runners. He's got the potential winning run right there at first base as Kuhns fought off an 0-2 count to draw a walk. Good at bat by Chris Kuhns.
Spychalski, I think, is going to try. Jeff Sefcik said he's very good at putting the ball in play and going with the pitch. As much as we've seen Clark painting the outside corner, you may see him try and dump one down the right field line, and that could be enough to score two.
Well, good speed on the bases. Butler on second, McHouston on first. One out. Driscoll trails by a run. Spychalski right back to the box. One out, two outs, that's it! What a finish! 1-6-3. A sea of red in the infield.
What a great play. Field your position, be sure of the throw, and guns it to first. 1-6-3, and it's a double state championship for Pleasant Plains. What a great moment for them.
As the coach, Dave Greer, his 11th season, he has coached these kids since some of them were in kindergarten.
A real classy move here by Jeff Sefcik. He just went over to his guys, goes, get out here. It's their moment, let's congratulate them.
Both teams will line up and shake hands if anybody's got any strength left, but what a ball game and what a finish. Bang, bang, bang. The ball went right back to Clark. Watch it here, and he starts the 1-6-3 to end it.
Right there, Bensko. Dusty Bensko guns it over, and there it is. Roth says, I got it.
Those gloves are in orbit. We'll be back. There are your champs. The Cardinals from Pleasant Plains. Well, in a game that a lot of people didn't want to see end and a lot of folks thought never might end, it certainly did in dramatic fashion. Pleasant Plains with a four-run seventh inning coming from behind to take a state championship out of Driscoll's hands by a score of 10-9. Our Taco Bell game summary, well, you really don't have enough room to put all the highlights of this one in, but that four-run seventh inning, David, for Pleasant Plains, and Before that, Dusty Bensko for the Cardinals, those two mammoth home runs, the grand slam and the solo. And not to mention, we must mention, the normally sure-handed Driscoll Highlanders. Four errors and several other misplays that that led to runs by just not making the plays cleanly.
Well, the interesting part of that four-run seventh inning, Dusty Bensko struck out in that inning, and an outstanding pitch from C. Glenn Camas tied him up inside, and you think of Pleasant Plains, you think of Dusty Bensko, but they're not a one-man operation. Well-coached, well-oiled, they win a state championship, and you're right, they snatched it right out of the hands of Driscoll, who took that three-run lead into the seventh.
Well, Pleasant Plains, the administrators, and then all the coaches. There you see Dave Greer getting congratulated, getting a championship medal. And let's take a look at our Pepsi play of the game in that seventh inning. Aaron Zirko with a shot to right field. Spychowski can't come up with it cleanly, and coming around all the way from first, just DeRocco. And that proved to be the winning run in an absolutely incredible ball game. To everything, there is a season, there's a time for joy, a time for tears. There's the joy side. And of course, for Driscoll, there are a lot of tears over down that third baseline. What a night it has been. The first team in school history, the first school in IHSA history to win a basketball championship and a baseball championship in the same year, and really with the same athletes. 12 members of the basketball team, the starting five, and many more reserves all play baseball, as you would expect in a school of fewer than 400 students, student athletes. Ryan Nelson, one of the seniors, getting his medal. And again, so many of these players, David, they're going to be back as juniors and seniors next year. We may well be doing this again.
Well, their baseball team is where the basketball team was a year ago. Going into the basketball season, there wasn't the huge expectation level, and they surface on the scene and they get it done and win a championship. Baseball, there were more expectations. Now there'll be even bigger expectations
right
next year.
Well, last year they were knocked out by Tutopolis, a longtime rival. Of course, the team they beat in the basketball finals was also Tutopolis, but Tutopolis beat them in last year's state tournament. And this year they just came through, and they came off the floor in incredible fashion. Well, in closing, it has been quite a night here at Lamphere Park in Central Illinois, where the weather was perfect. The game, well, certainly not an object of perfection, but in terms of emotion, in terms of thrills, absolutely perfect. High school sports at their finest. A lot of fun, great thrills.
There's nothing better than high school sports. It's so pure. I mean, you see the joy, and you talk to the athletes. We talked to Dusty Bensko earlier today. You don't get any of the canned quotes that you would normally get from the professional athlete. He just said, I wish this would go on forever. I'm not tired. Play another game. I love this. That's what it's all about.
That's right. No shoe contracts, no big endorsements. This is, you know, there you see Jeff Sefcik, and a disappointed but still very proud group of Highlanders came here looking for an unprecedented fourth Class A championship. And Jeff was looking for his third, but something tells me he will be back
They'll
in the
be
not
back.
Too distant future.
Great program. They'll be back.
And there is the winner's trophy. Up, up, and away. You can't throw this one in the pool, but it'll take a few laps around the infield, we'll be sure. Pleasant Plains, the Cardinals are the champs. Pick your sport, they're tops. Your Class A champions, Pleasant Plains over Addison Driscoll, 10-9. So for David Kaplan, I'm Mike Lederman. Jim Corno and our crew saying so long from Lamphere Park in Springfield. You've been watching the year 2000 IHSA Class A Baseball Championship on Fox Sports Net and Intersport Television. So long, everybody.